you, and then invite you to the even more competitive community. With our hoping this year to have 200 members in a year. So how are we going to achieve it? First of all, we propose to have a marketing campaign and we raise the public awareness and the recognition on the mailing system so that we can actually attract more shippers to use the joining program. And the shippers, as far as the two-tier system and the GDP development, can actually help to do the brewing request to attract also the carriers joining the program as well. So let's talk about the marketing campaign first. The campaign should be launched as soon as possible, and we will propose that there should be a redesign of the logo, saying that I am we, as far as the GFA's name is, so that the general public can actually understand what the label actually means. And most important, they can understand that the firms or the shippers with that label actually means that they were very green. Also, we propose to have the annual prize giving ceremony to award the outstanding members. We will also invite the media to come, and then they can actually make use of their frequency. Also, we'll be trying to like to collaborate with other NGOs and to launch some kind of exhibition and campaign. Again, it is to raise the awareness and the recognition on the management system. Finally, we will have the active promotion to send an email and to send other kind of promotional material to the potential members. So, be creating the perfect recognitions on the labels. It actually can make our label and label system more valuable to shippers. And then it can be attract more shippers to join them to join the campaign program. And after attracting the shippers, the two-tier system can actually help to put more carriers to join the system as well. And in the first tier, it will be supported on the individual level. It will be similar to what CFA is doing. Well, for the second tier, it will be on the total supply chain level. This means for shippers which want to get that label, they will have to be included in the total supply chain. This means they will have to collaborate with also the green trading partners. So it will be another creative path to attract more carriers to join the program as well.
So we now talk about the GDP component. GEP is a platform that is proposed in food for green and renewable platform. GEP has six major functionalities for today, but we're going to focus on two of them, both of them. First of all, it is about data management. GEP sources data and information from a large number of different data sources. But you have to pass two main data collection tools for GEP to collect data. Once the data is ready, we will put them into data analysis phase. We propose to collaborate with Bing and Air Asia to build an analytics tool based on their green truck tool. With this solution, we can analyze the data, visualize the data, and most importantly, show how much reduction in carbon emissions was done through our efforts. We recognize that the Asia-Pacific carrier market is highly fragmented, so we propose two different data collection tools to cater the needs of different carriers. The internet is designed for large-scale corporations with ERP solutions. ERP solutions are capable of generating reports on regular intervals, and by incorporating these reports into our internet, we can perform data extraction and analysis. The second solution is the mobile application with cloud system. This system is designed for small to medium-sized carriers which are running on individual basis. Such application is able to track the distance, time and route of the journey of each carrier, and they will also be equipped with interactive interface and user-friendly interface at different languages to facilitate data input at different points. Another very important feature of GDP is our online trading platform. There are two elements in online trading platform. First of all, it is about the carrier profile. By carrier profiling, I mean that we are analyzing carrier information through a weighted model. Then we will propose a green score for each of these carriers. With these green scores, we can put the data into search engine optimization. By that, we mean through our platform, we can rank the search results of carriers through their scores. So that the greener the carrier, the higher the ranking, and the more business opportunities they will be able to ensure in our system. Now you may ask, why is our system so attractive to our stakeholders? Well, we rank the carriers according to field scores, and that means for shippers, they can easily recognize the most efficient carrier and the system, and they can reduce the cost of the supply chain as a whole. On the other hand, we have a collection of wide variety of carrier products. That means we can share this information of extensive information about carriers that can improve the data transparency across the supply chain. While on the carrier side, the two-tier system that is proposed can actually help carriers to get recognition through our system easily. They may use the GFN label to promote and differentiate themselves from other competitors. And on the other hand, and most important actually, our system can actually link these individual small and medium carriers through our system to a large amount of business opportunities through our shipping.
In light of the constrained human resources and the budget, we would like to engage students into our functional teams. And the students will be collaborating in the form of interns and final year project students, and they will be led by a team of top management from GFA, which is hired from a pool of industry professionals and management experts. They will be forced to be more engaged by handling the by the top management who control the comments of the recommendation letter and also the grades of the final year project. So as most of employees in the company would be students, we will greatly reduce our cost for this project, and hence it can make this process more sustainable. Some of you may doubt whether students have the ability to deal with complex functional team projects, and especially the IT projects. So this is actually one of the projects that I have done in the past, and it is a very similar extranet system. And I successfully built it by myself in 3 months. And this shows that students have the ability to build quality products on time. And after describing the implementation, core implementation plans in details, let us step back and look whether the total solution itself is aligned to our goals. First of all, the first three solutions, marketing campaign, two-tier system, and also the formation of student the GDP deployment plan would help us to attract new membership and encourage label upgrade. For the marketing campaign, it would help us to gain reputation and also create the you have, I have psychology. So if I'm a company with only one green lead and my competitor is having two, so I would be strive to get two leads in the future. And we further enhance the cost reduction incentive by having a GDP system so that the smaller companies would be incentivized to join our program and use the GDP system. Apart from the aims we want to achieve for the company, and we have considered the financial factors as well. For the current business model, we are charging members who have higher annual revenue for more membership fees. And we want to use the GDP system to help the companies to reduce their total costs and hence increase their annual revenue, and so that they have to pay more annual membership fees in the future. And last but not least, the formation of the student teams will greatly reduce the cost. GFA shouldn't just stop after they have reached the 200 members goal, and we should talk about the future. The Ask One team believes that with collaboration with the government is one of the most important plans in the future, and because they have a lot of resources provided for us to help, and also they have to help us in marketing and promotion, etc. And to expand into the Asia-Pacific region, as we are hiring some professionals in the industry, we would increase our we would further expand our business model by providing free consulting services. And the role of AskWhen is to in this project is to be a low-priced IT consultant, because we just want to get the reputation of Google for this project. However, we want to gain a long-term partnership with GFA as the prioritized IT consulting service partner, where if members want any free logistics IT consulting services, GFA should be joining us. And this is all for today, and we now open questions to the floor. Thank you. Thank you.
So about the data version of the question like this, the intent to do and to match. First of all, we do require the application provider to provide some information about their connectivity. Let's say they have implemented or installed local entries of their network. We do require them to provide the respective information to us. And on the other hand, we also have the stuff which means that
try to reduce the cost for students by having students engage in the projects and try to have our business model including the student having green logistics consulting services and also try to try to include our membership fee and then
for example, we're actually recruiting professionals at the international level. So we tend to employ around 4 professionals in our professional team to lead students to care of the course. So these are the major courses of our staff. Yet we propose to have, for example, an increased revenue for our members so that we can have more membership fee and teachers to cover up these courses.
We will provide the tailor-made customer services by making use of our data to provide to the business. And also, we will try to find the account. Because there are all certain and logistic-related voyages or infrastructure and even projects set by the government. So, the government will also be another source of information for the customer in our customer service. So, it will be our revenue generating model to sustain our long-term operation. Now, we will also try to lower the cost by having the students in one organization.
You said about cost reduction, and the second slide, I think, mentioned redesigning the logo. We put A as an identity, and by changing that, we're going to incur cost by changing letterhead, signatures, print. We'll also potentially lose members through our identity. Could you share your comments on this, please?
Actually, about the local innovation thing, first, we think it is important to incorporate our GFO branding in the logo, and we have to incorporate a very distinctive design on our logo. That's one of the goals of these 2 years ago. So, about the branding thing, we innovate on logo.
I go back to the financials, the question on financials. Do you have a financial statement of a cash flow from where the fund will come to pay for the students or the industry experts which you want to do?
Well, to be honest, we didn't estimate the total charge that was incurred and then the local students in the conversation. But we can estimate that there will be a very proportionate future income goal. This is because we are employing around 4 experts in our team, which is critical because so we are enabling a great possibility of income in the future.
Actually, we also understand that in order to use those kind of IT solutions or any IT projects, they actually will charge a lot. Because our IT consultants
Summit, we tried to build a kind of a long-term relationship with GFA, so that we were trying to capitalize the lower price for the energy. But in the long run, when they can actually sustain their business, and we can actually show them kind of build up we may be their IT infrastructure before maintenance or the operator. So at that time, it will be kind of like a long-term relationship. And when we see how many champions does better than our IT contract.
I learned from your presentation that the way to collect data is either through Kotlin or through looking up your system with ERP system. Which sounds quite big. I think quite big to be looking up your system with ERP systems like Fitchip or Cloudflare or Mobile HP. So what is your thought on this and like, how much time do you anticipate for this?
As a student, I think I'm more than technical. I think it's a big
Thank you very much, Ms. White.